What's up, YouTube? My name is Hyper, and in today's video, we're going to be looking at three different things that you can do to spice up your creative build battles. Make sure to stick around to the end, because I have made a tutorial on a highly requested thing, so you'll have to watch to the end to find out what that thing is. Quick announcement before the video starts, I have joined SGO Gaming as a content creator. You've probably heard of them before, they're a pretty big team on Instagram, an amazing team, everybody in there is so chill, so kind. So I will be playing for them for the, hopefully, very long next period of my career. So massive thanks to them. I will be posting two videos a week now, one on Wednesday and one on Sunday, and I will try to get them out at 6:30, but my internet and my computer is so slow, so that may not be exactly those times, but stay tuned for Wednesday and Sunday evenings for brand new videos, brand new content. I've got a lot of fun ideas planned. And yeah, one last thing I'd like to say before we get into the video is I am, again, saving up for a PC, so if you would like to support me on my grind for $1,500, you can do so by donating a link to the donation place is in the description below. And if you can't donate, that's completely fine. Just by watching this video, you help me out. But if you would like to support me, but can't donate or don't want to donate, you can come over to the item shop, go to the bottom right-hand corner, press on the Support a Creator tab, type in my code, H-Y-P-Y-A, Hypya, press accept, and then anything you buy in the item store will help me out a ton. Again, thank you guys for all the support. Thank you SGO Gaming for signing me. And let's get into this juicy video. Okay, so the first thing I'm going to show you is a high ground retake. Now, I may make a few mistakes in this video because my ping is quite a lot higher than usual and I'm getting quite a bit of packet loss at times, so I do apologize for that, but I will try my best to make these as clean as possible. So, we're going to start this retake by building up. It can just be single ramps or you can scissor ramp, and then you're going to place a floor and a cone and basically do the start of every high ground retake ever. So you're going to double edit these two, place the two ramps in the floor, and then from here we're going to edit this floor in the two tiles like that. We're going to jump, place a cone here and here with a floor and a ramp, and it'll look like this, but the ramp will be facing this way. So another example of that, or a better example of that, is going to come up like this. Two ramps, and then we're going to jump like that. And then from here, you're going to edit these two tiles. You can just edit this one tile, but I just prefer to edit the two tiles. But if you do choose to edit the one tile, make sure it's this tile right here, because if you do it with this tile here, you're going to have to come all the way up to here before you can place the ramp, which makes the next bit of this impossible. Just make sure you're selecting either this tile or both of them. Then what you're going to do is you're going to place a wall here, and I'm going to attempt to do this with 3% packet loss. We're going to go here and jump like that onto a ramp and a floor, and then from here we're going to place another cone, another wall, and then side jump, but landing on this ramp. It's just hard to do with this much packet loss and ping. But you're going to land on this ramp here, and then from here you can scissor ramp and do whatever you want. And yeah, so that's pretty much how to do it. So this next thing I'm going to show you is something that you can do after a high ground retake, or just something that you would do when you don't want to do a full high ground retake but still want a little bit of high ground. So what it is it's going to be a double side jump but spiced up a bit. So basically you're going to place your cone, and normally you've seen side jumps and you just jump out like that, just straight forward, nothing too fancy about them, and they work just fine. They work just as well as the thing I'm about to show you, but they're just not as cool as what I'm about to show you. So the thing that I do is what I like to call the hyper side jump. I say this because I personally have never seen anybody do side jumps the way I do them. But if somebody has done them before me, then I apologize for stealing this. Please forgive me. But basically, what we're going to do is we're going to come up to our cone here. And instead of doing a normal side jump, we're going to run really, really up close to the roof here. So probably two-thirds up of this ramp here. And we're going to basically spin from facing straight forward, having our crosshair in line with this, around until we're facing outwards like that. So it's going to be like that. You're going to spin from here around like that. If you're on PC, you can quickly flick to it. But if you're on controller, which funnily enough, this trick is actually easy on controller just because of how the camera movement and all of that works, you can do it more smooth. But anyway, let's just get onto the side jump. So you come up and you spin around like that. It's not really that much faster. It's not, you know, that much more efficient, but it just looks a lot cleaner. Like the spin around just looks so smooth. And when you tie it in with the next bit, it's beautiful. So the next part is going to be the second side jump. So once you land this one, you're going to be on this ramp, right about here. And what you're going to want to do is look two-thirds up of the ramp so you can place the cone. You want to then place that cone. And then last time we were facing our ramp and spun around like that. This time, instead of spinning to the right, we're going to spin the opposite direction to the left. So basically the same thing, but to the left. And we're going to basically run up to the same point, spin around, and then jump onto this one here. Again, the spins, they're not more effective than just a normal side jump, but they definitely look a lot smoother. And when you tie them both together in a full speed, it's very, very clean. And adding it after like a high ground retake or something just adds a little bit more spice to your creative high ground retake. Something I forgot to mention when I was talking about the double side jumps is you can't stop your movement once. It's very important that when you're doing this high ground sort of double cone jump, full speed, you don't stop your movement. So when you jump and you land, you know, on this bit, you can't stop and you know, get your bearings. You just have to land, keep running, and go for the second side jump. That being said, when you are first learning it, or you're just practicing the 360 side jumps, and you've just landed it, and you're not comfortable with the second one yet, that's completely fine. You can stop your movement there, to practice, of course, or slow it down. But it's just important that when you speed it up to full speed, to do in a high ground retake for a clip or something, that you are not stopping your movement once. You just keep running, keep running. It's okay to let your character slow down, but it can't stop, otherwise it just looks choppy and not as good. The final thing I'm going to show you in today's video is my famous hypercone. So this is something that I made up when I was bored, and it's basically an extreme version of the well-known Thwifo cone. I posted it on my Instagram and it blew up, getting almost 10,000 views, I think, something crazy. And everybody wanted a tutorial on it. So that's what I'm going to bring you today. If you haven't seen it already, this is what the Instagram clip looked like. My life a movie, the way they be acting. She said that she like on my eyelids. This life I gotta appreciate. Remember the time I ain't had this. But when they see me in a mansion, tell me that they proud and they clapping. Ain't hard, I had to demonstrate. Honestly, I'm really just rapping. On her grandma got fans and they love me. On her grandma got haters, they hate me. They said that this nigga fucking nerd. So as you can see, it is pretty crazy, pretty cool, pretty darn effective. And yeah, so I'm going to show you how I did it right now. So here's how to do it. what you want to do is you want to run up your ramp, and unlike a normal FIFO cone where it doesn't matter where on the ramp you stand, with the hyper cone you have to come very, very far up, so all the way to the top of the ramp. That way you can get the 3-tile wall off. Then from here, what you want to do is you want to place a wall here, or you can even box this whole thing in, but you want to place a wall here, and then you want to, after you've done that, you want to place 2 cones, one here and one here. You want to place a cone down here and a ramp. Then you want to place a floor and a ramp. You want to finish these last 2 cones. And then you're going to ramp up like that. And then, whoops, if I can even 90, crank 2 90s. And you'll be facing this way. Very, very far above your opponent. So, I'm going to show you a full speed example of my point of view right now. So that concludes today's video. I hope you guys enjoyed it. If you did like it, leave a like on the video. And if you really liked it, consider subscribing for 2 videos a week now, doubling up the content, getting my grind on. I've got some pretty fun ideas planned, so stay tuned for them. And yeah, again, thank you for watching, and I'll catch you in the next video. Peace out.